Thank you. Father, thank you so much for bringing us all here together today in preparation for Thanksgiving coming up. And we have many thanks for you. And we're just happy to wake up every day and breathe another breath. And we're so grateful for your mercy and your grace. So as we put together this offering today, we just want you to know that it's from our heart and it's with our love. We pray it in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
She wants to talk to you about some of the youth fundraiser things that take place. And here you go. Thank you.
Okay, we're trying to raise money for youth camp. And we want to get a lecture everybody. And so Melanie and Joy and Melanie's sister. So the first ones are called Art Brownies, and they're just $10. The next one is Gourmet Hot Chocolate, and that's $10. The jams are all five, wild elderberry jam, and Arbor Grape, and Plum Jelly, and Blackberry. Not sure the tag on that one yet. But So there'll be, as we're standing in line for dinner, the youth will be back at the table, and we'll just have you put your name on the back of an envelope, and how much you're giving, we'll put it in an envelope and give it to Pam. So anyway, we appreciate that. They've made enough that we can earn $600 towards camp with just what these days.
And so these, basically these, four of these, but they're different types of jams. These are $5 a piece, $20 for all four, okay?
Right.
I bought four of them already to help them out. So hope you guys will do the same. Make a wonderful Christmas present, it's really safe. How many ever ate homemade jelly before?
Oh, yes.
This is all homemade. Because they got store-bought stuff, man.
Yeah, this is good stuff. And since I'm up here, hello Florence, hello Karen, and the Lyman family.
All watching this on video. Amen.
We miss you.
Praise the Lord. And we sure appreciate Rachel doing that. Now, also, I got a young man asking to come and share his testimony. And next time, I'm going to pick somebody else to share their testimony. Come on, brother. Come up here and share your testimony that God has been doing. I got others who want to share their testimonies, and we'll get around to them in a week or so.
Good morning. If you know me or knew anything about me years ago, you know this is the last place I ever was. And, you know, the Lord's worked in my life in quite a few different ways. And unexpectedly, it's not the direction I chose to go and didn't want to go at first, but I didn't really have a choice. He paid for it. I, at one point in time, I lost my job and my home, and pretty much in a situation with my young family. But I didn't have a lot of hope. I was new with myself. Made a lot of phone calls about looking around and find a place to live. And since I didn't have a job, and, you know, verifiable income that would be a rent to me. He didn't have any interest in really speaking. And I ran out of opportunities. I was in a motel with my family. And that night, everybody went to sleep, and I sat there and thought to myself, I prayed to the Lord. I asked him for guidance, for some kind of relief. And the next morning, I was getting up. I was going to go off before everybody else, get us something to eat. And my phone rang. I answered the phone, and there was a man on the other end that said, I got your message. I'm looking for, to see if you wanted to rent this place. He says, do you believe in God? And I said, yes. So he said, I need you to get to Coquille right now, because they got three other people who were looking to rent the place. And the first one here, it's the house. So I didn't have a lot of money at the time. I sold what possessions I had to do a price to me and raised the Coquille. I got there, spoke with the man. He said he'd rent to my family. So I got us a place to live for 30 days with the money that I had, and I needed to find work desperately. And so I got another phone call from the gentleman. He said, you know, if you can rent the lower unit out for me, I would make things right with you. And so, you know, I hadn't rented places out. I wasn't a landlord. I didn't know much about it, but I figured I'd at least go down to the library, get on the internet, and put an ad out so people could come and take a look at it, get it rented out, and would maybe buy me a little more time where I was living. So I went down there, got on the Facebook, started trying to put this ad together to rent that place out. I was having all kinds of problems with it. I couldn't get it to work right. And it ended up landing me on a page where someone was looking for help, needed work. And I called that guy up, and he said, well, I'll have you start the next day. So I met him there. It just so happens he was an elder for the Hauser Community Church, and started working with him. My truck started going bad. He said, here's my old pickup. It's a work truck for you to drive. Go ahead and use it. So I did. And I times asked my wife, I said, you know, why don't you give this a shot? Because I'm starting to hear some stuff on there that's really making sense in my life. And, you know, at first she was apprehensive. She's like, you know, I'll listen. And I don't think she did. And then I come home again and I say some more about to her. I finally got her to listen for a week. Give me just a week's time to listen. And she did. She listened to it. And then pretty soon, 3 o'clock every day, the radio show with Pastor Mike Hester was on playing it. And then Taylor and I started talking. You know, we're like, we need to find ourselves a church. And, you know, we had offers to go to Powder Community Church. We had offers to go to Emmanuel here in Tokyo, all different churches in the area. And we spoke to a couple friends of ours, and some people recommended this church. And so, you know, we were apprehensive. We were kind of freaked out, you know. There's a lot of snippy Christians out there. There's a lot of people who turn their nose down at you and look the other way. And we thought, you know, we're going to give this church a chance. And it was a big step for us to get up that morning and come here and walk in the door. Miss Marjorie hit me right up the back door, gave me a big hug. I didn't even think. It's like, man, there's people that seem to just really care. Well, this last year, November 9th was our 1 year anniversary of coming here, being at this church. And, found family here. People that I care about and love every one of you. I look forward to coming and seeing you every chance to get. And I'm appreciative of all of you. And, you know, God is, I want to say thank you to every one of you. It's a great family to have. I love you all.
That's all right, isn't it?
Yeah.
So I just wanted you guys to hear these testimonies. I've got Billy to come up and prepare yourself, and I'm going to let him just talk to you about his testimony. And God has really blessed our church. You probably noticed it's been under attack, and a lot of these things happen because the enemy knows that God is touching you and helping you in your life. Amen. Praise the Lord. And good testimony. Appreciate it. You could want to share it to me for 5 minutes. Pastor, I got to share this testimony. I want to share it. I said, we'll get to it. We'll get, you know how it is. Week after week. And I said, okay. Next Sunday. All right. And so it worked out. Can't say amen. Well, are you guys having children's church today, or are you living them all in here?
Yes, we're going to be in here, sir.
Oh, you guys want to watch my famous turkey tune sermon? How many of you remember my famous turkey tune sermon? All right. Give thanks. And we're supposed to do that. But it's kind of hard when things are going rough. I mean, you know what I'm talking about. It's kind of hard to give thanks, especially when you have had a week or a bad month or a bad year. But hey, the Bible says that we're to give thanks no matter what. No matter how tough it gets, man, we got to raise those arms up like lightning rods and say, God, I thank you. Can you say amen? I praise you. I worship you. I give thanks to you. Because guess what? You allow me to wake up one more day to give you glory. Can you say amen to that? Did you know that? You're on borrowed time. This is God's time. He loaned all this to you for you to give him worship and give him praise. And I'm so grateful to you, man. How about you? But before we start, why don't we pray? May the Lord bless this time as we come together, as we give thanks. And Father, we thank you for everything that you've done for us. And I know there's a lot of people missing today, a lot of sickness. But Lord, I know you're going to help us through it. You always have and always will. And I just want to give you praise and glory. Lord, thank you for this young man's testimony today. It's inspiring and, Lord, touching as well. I've watched God completely pull him and his family from out of the gutter. And Lord, as you prosper and bless him so greatly and so much, I thank you for doing that and praise you for it. Lord, I thank you for bringing him to this church. Lord, I thank you so much for everything you've done for them and for us. And I just want to give you praise and honor and glory. I want to give you thanks, Lord. So let my lips become your lips, Let my thoughts become your thoughts. Let my eyes become your eyes, and my heart become your heart, as I set forth towards you perpetually. As I give God glory and honor, I surrender myself totally to Him and His Holy Spirit. I give praise and glory and honor in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Can you say amen? Well, let's give God thanks. And you know what? It's been a rough week. It's been a rough night. It was a rough night for me. Boy, last night I had indigestion like crazy. How many else had problems? Similar problems. Woke up about 2 o'clock this morning, woke my wife up. She says, "Are you okay?" And I says, "Not really, but I'm going to be all right." Amen? I says, "It's one of those times you just got to fight the devil through the whole night." How many know what I'm talking about? Wonderful things are going to happen tomorrow, and that's the reason why. But I praise God. Can you say amen? I wouldn't trade it for anything. And so I want you to know, this is the reason we give God thanks, even during the bad stuff as well as the good times. Amen. Let's continue today. Thanksgiving is a wonderful time of the year to thank God for all the things He's done for us. 1 Chronicles chapter 16, verse 7. On that day, David first delivered the psalm unto the hand of Asaph, his brethren, and to thank the Lord. And he said, "Oh, give thanks to the Lord. Call upon his name. Make known his deeds among the people. I tell the world about God." Can you say amen? Make known his wonderful deeds, his wonderful works. I don't know about you, but this is good air I'm breathing today. Can you say amen to that? Hallelujah. In a little while, I'm going to eat some good food. How about that? Praise the Lord. I tell you what, we got good air to breathe. We got good food. We got warm electricity keeping our church warm today. How many are glad for the heat is on? Because it's a lot colder outside than it is inside. I want you to know, we got a lot to be thankful for. You got a job. I tell you what, you got a car. If you got gasoline and you got money to put gas in that car, you're blessed. I want you to know that. You're really blessed. You got medical plan. You got a doctor. How many got a good doctor? You're blessed. Amen. How many got a nurse in your family? You're even double blessed. Amen. My goodness, God has blessed you over and over and over and over. And I want you to know we're going to give God glory and praise because we love you. Amen. Make known his deeds. Make known his word. Tell the world about Jesus Christ. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Tell them about Jesus. And Jesus will make sure, guess what? He'll make sure you have a voice to do that. Amen.
Amen.
As we continue today, give thanks because God is good. 1 Chronicles chapter 16, verse 34. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His mercy endures forever. I put you a little note here. Hopefully, the supply chain issues mean actually this. What do you think about that? How do you like that? Amen. Oh, give thanks to the Lord. Why? Because His mercy endures forever. God's mercy is everlasting to everlasting. His love is everlasting to everlasting. His joy is everlasting to everlasting. His peace is everlasting. I don't know about you, but you can't come to church today and go home without anything, because guess what? God is everything. Am I right, Brother Jeff? God is everything. Amen. Brother Chris, amen. Sister, amen. God is everything. Man, He is my everything. He is my all. How many remember the voice? Mm-hmm. Amen. Both great and small, He gave His life for me and made everything new. He's my everything. So how about you? Amen. Is He your everything? He is my everything.
Amen.
He's all I need. Jesus. sin. And he's all I need. Amen. Give thanks because God is what? Good. God is good. Someone asks you, what's happening? You tell them, God is good. God is good. Guess what? He's good because he's good to you. Amen. As we continue today, God is truly good. Psalm 25, verse 8, good, upright is the Lord. Therefore he teaches sinners in the way. The humble he guides in justice, and the humble he teaches his way. I put that just for Larry. I don't know, Larry, you still look like a turkey. What do you say?
Good.
Can't camouflage you or what you are, brother. Amen. Remember that. Amen. But I want you to know God is good. There's a chorus. God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me. He has done great things. He has done great things. He has done great things. Bless his holy name. I will bless the Lord with my soul. All that is within me, I will bless his holy name. Amen. Those are precious old songs. Amen.
Amen.
Maybe next Sunday I'll leave a few more of them. All right? Is that all right? Good and upright is the Lord. God is good. God is truly good. I don't know about you, but he gave us a nice sun to warm us up during the day. And he put a wonderful moon up there to make sure we sleep at night. You know, he's got his own nightlight. How many got your own nightlight? I got a little bitty one at night out there. Man, God's got a great big one up there. And man, at nighttime, he just shines. I love it. How about you? You know why he put that nightlight up there? And that sun up there? Because of us. Yeah, us. The Bible says he created everything. And guess who he created last? You, me.
Mm-hmm.
He created us on the sixth day. He created all the animals. He created the heavens and the earth on the first day. He created all the trees, the herbs, the oceans. He created all the seas, land masses. He created the sun, the moon. But guess what? He created us last. You know what the best part about it? He said, I'm going to give them charge over everything. All that I created, he said, I'm going to put them in charge of it. So guess what? That moon belongs to us. That sun belongs to us. You know why? Because our Father gave it to us. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Couple said, you don't need real estate? I sure do. I got a great big sun up there. Got my name written all over it. Guess what? The Bible says the earth and the fullness thereof is belongs to the Lord. So I am an heir to Jesus Christ. Amen. God is truly good. Let us look on. Taste how good our God is. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who trusts in him. Oh, fear the Lord, you his saints. There is no luck to those who fear him. So he said, oh, taste the Lord. You and I need to taste the Lord. Can you say amen? We need to taste him. Why? Because he's so good. Taste the Lord, the Bible says. I don't know about you, but I love it. Taste apple pie. How many else like it? Taste apple pie. How many else like pumpkin pie? How many like any type of pie? Just raise your hand. I tell you what, the Bible says, taste and see that the Lord is what good. I put over here, I think he's off to the dentist. I heard something about the cavity getting filled. That's a cute one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Let us move on. Sing praises unto the Lord. Psalm 30, verse 4 says, sing praise to the Lord, you saints of his. God is holy. He's holy, and you and I need to thank the Lord for this. It is my firm belief that a low-carb diet, along with exercise, will lower your risk of becoming this year's Thanksgiving dinner by 73%.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, he said, nobody buys a six-pound turkey. There we go. He's got one there. He's got one. Oh, taste the Lord. Praise the Lord. God is good. Amen. Sing praises to Him. I don't know about you, but there's nothing wrong with at work time saying a chorus or saying a song. How many of you catch yourself singing a chorus to the Lord? Amen. Excuse me. You and I need to sing to the Lord. Sing praises to Him. He said, I can't carry a tune in about it. It don't matter. How could you sing? It just use those lips for Jesus Christ. Can you say
amen?
Let them fly. Yes. Let them fly for the Lord.
Amen.
There's an old saying, loose lips sink ships. How do you know what I mean? Let your lips fly for the Lord.
That's right.
Let it out. Praise the Lord. When you walk into a group of people, just say, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. How about you when you come to church? Should be the first thing you should say to one another. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm in the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
See, we didn't get our troubles back.
Mm-hmm.
We let all these troubles and trials dog us down and sap us of our joy. And when we come, we need to release all this anxiety. And let God have it. And guess what? He brings that joy back into us. Makes us happy again. How many know this when you come? You're all down and out until you come to church. And after you come to church, you feel better when you go home. Why? Because you let all that anxiety out. And guess what you did? You sang praises unto the Lord. You and I should be raising our hands during them songs and glorifying God. Oh God, thank you. God, thank you for saving me. God, thank you for giving me a job. Amen. God, thank you for giving me a family. God, thank you for healing me. God, thank you for helping me and helping my children. Thank you, God. Lord, even though my kids don't deserve it, how many know your kids don't deserve it? You don't deserve it. Even though you don't deserve it, my kids don't deserve it, God, but I thank you. I glorify. Because nobody deserves the goodness of God. Nobody here deserves it. You're unworthy. I am too. We're totally unworthy of everything that God does for us. That's why it's important that you and I praise Him and worship Him and glorify Him and give thanks. You know what? If we would get back into the thankful business, I think we would get out of the problem business a lot quicker and sooner. Hello? How many ever think your way out of a situation? That's what you got to do sometimes. You got to thank God to get you out of that situation. Amen. Sing praises unto the Lord. All you saints, give thanks at the remembrance of what? His name is holy. The Lord said, be ye holy. For I am holy, saith the Lord. If God is holy, you and I should be holy too. Can you say amen to that? As we continue, I will give thanks to God forever. Psalm 79, verse 13. So we, your people, sheep of your pasture, we will give you thanks forever. We will show forth your praise to all generations. That means you and I must be in a continual atmosphere of giving God glory and praise. Man, every day I thank God. I thank Him for my house. I thank Him for my job. I thank Him. I even thank Him for the trees that are outside. How about you guys? I got a whole bunch of trees on the property. Don't have nothing. Don't know what to do with them, but look at them. Hey, they're pretty to look at. You know? But I thank God for them. Thank God for the heat. Thank God for my life. thank God for my daughter, Pam, and my other daughter, Sylvia. I thank God for my great-grandchildren and my great-grandchildren. I thank God for each of you for being in my life. And you allow me to be in your life. Because it's important that we thank God for one another. And appreciate one another. So it's so important to love each other and be considerate towards each other. Can you say amen? Boy, last night we had more people here, and I didn't have enough pizza. That was the first time I've ever had more people than pizza. How about that? Won't catch me off next year, amen. We'll have more pizza next year. But I
think Jerry will be here next year.
But we sure had a good time. How many were here? How many like going to church today? Mm-hmm. How many of you? A whole bunch of them. Praise God. How about that? Even for a turkey, Tommy wasn't very bright. The farmer invited him over today. Like that one, about you?
Mm-hmm.
All right. I will give thanks to the Lord. Amen. Lastly, let's enter into his gates with thanksgiving. Psalm 100, verse 3. Know the Lord, he is good, he is God. It is he who made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving. Into his courts with praise. Be thankful to him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. His truth endures to all generations. So what? Enter into his gates. When you come through these gates, when you come into this house of God, enter into his gates with Don't ask you, oh, you come to church? I came to give God glory. I come to worship God. I come to let God know I love him. I care about him. That is the whole reason I come. I didn't come for any other reason today but to worship God. You understand? To give thanks. Amen. Good conversation back there. Brother Ed, you got a good conversation? You want to share it to me? How about you? All right, thank you. You're on my time now, brother. Let's look here. Cough. Feeling a bit feverish? Yeah. Tired, headache, lost the smell. Taste. COVID symptoms. How do you like that?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Oh, here's one. Looks like they're still nervous about big gatherings. We might be safe for another year. Now, you guys know I'm just speaking on today. I'm just kidding today. I'm out of the fire. All right, you guys know like the next one. I see you're surrounded by family. Well, not your family. You guys like this.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I see you're surrounded by family. Well, not your family. All right, let's look on. Dude, I have a ton of online followers. They all want to have me over for dinner. All right. Pretty good, huh? Yeah, I know. He's looking, he's a pastor. I don't know where he's coming from. All right, how about one more? Gene was beginning to regret his neck tattoo.
Took me a second.
That's a new one. How do you like that one?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Okay, I got another one here. Guys, I'm not kidding. I'm a robot for the future. Your lives are in danger. Come with me if you want to live. Unfortunately, no one believed the turkey there. All right, you guys love it.
favorite one.
Many of them are going through challenges right now, God. I pray, Lord God, that you help them, Lord, and that you help them to overcome all these difficulties that they're experiencing right now. Many of them are going through the trial of faith right now. Some are going through temptation. Some are just going through the trials of faith. They're going through the fiery trials the Bible speaks about in the book of James and the book of Peter. And so, Lord, we pray for these as they go through these fiery trials, God. And, Lord, that they become overcomers in the name of Jesus Christ. And right now, as you're praying with me, say this prayer with me. Our Lord, we thank you for everything you've done for us.
Thank you for everything you've done.
And, Lord, we ask you now to help us.
Help
me, Lord. Help me recover. Help me overcome this anxiety. Help me overcome these problems. Help me overcome these trials. Please, God, help me. That's all you gotta say. Please, God, help me. Help me overcome. Give me strength, and I give you glory, God. For whatever outcome may come, I give you the praise and glory and honor in Jesus' wonderful name. I glorify you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I glorify you, God. I thank you, God. And I praise you. Oh, how wonderful and how good the Lord is. Amen, amen. How many believe God touched you today? Amen. He touched you today. Amen. Well, how about standing? Well, Well, you can sit there for a little bit because they're getting ready to do prepare for the bath. And so we're just going to take out time right now and visit and talk with each other, but I'm going to dismiss this in prayer. And then we'll all go to the dining hall, and then I'm going to pray with the food. And you're all welcome to stay and eat. They've got ham, they're going to have turkey back there. They've got all types of good things pretty close to them. And so you're going to be blessed, okay? Would you pray with me? Father, we thank you for allowing us to come to worship today. And we praise the Lord for everything he's done for us. Oh God, right now I just give you glory and honor in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you for everything you've done for us. I just praise God. And so Lord, I ask you now to go with us and be with us. And Lord, thank you so much again for touching the lives of all these people. And also touching me, God. And Lord, I thank you so much. In Jesus' name, amen.